Today, we get an interesting one after yesterday's discussion. The interview with Samuel Wise-Bangura do with the Minister of Health and Sanitation, Dr. Alpha Wuri. Yesterday, Udina had a talk about Choitram Hospital being charity or money making. Today we get an opportunity for listen to all waiting the minister lay na table. And before I go say any word, make a bring in Usman Toli. Make it try for prep the table for we fine. Yes, Usman Toli, welcome on board, sir.
Okay. First of all, I just want to thank the Minister of Health and Sanitation, Tijan Al-Sawuri, Dr. Tijan Al-Sawuri. I think he actually gave me a comprehensive report on the status quo on the health sector in the country. And if you think about it, it just talk about the core system, the challenges them, and the development where the sector will face not alone. But as we all know, say the health sector, now one of the most important sectors in the country. If we draw reference to what happened during the Ebola crisis, where the Ebola crisis destroyed so many other sectors in the country, including the economic sector. And quite a while ago, Naya, we discussed, say, now one of the shocks them, where government for the plan for all the time ahead. Because we all know some of the destructions them, where the Ebola crisis caused in our country, they destroy a lot of institutions them, destroy a lot of investment. We see a lot of investors them way kind of the country. You know, during the Ebola crisis, they therefore left. The mining sector therefore disintegrates. You know, so the private sector being disintegrated. A lot of things them happen. So the Ministry of Health and Sanitation, not a small ministry. But thank God, it looked like the doctor, he know what he did do. He get a lot of experience as soon as all these things. One of the things that we highlight in terms of the challenges, then, I think say my phone or the echo, eh?
No.
Because the echo on your side, now, yeah, okay, thank you. As I said, one of the major challenges then we face in terms of the health sector in our country, they, we know say we not been get the facilities then in place. We not been get the equipment in place. So consequently, where the Ebola kicking, it able expose most of them defect here. So from the previous government, they don't begin put modalities in place for make sure say then kind of a thing and they will be happen where the Ebola crisis kicking, it not gonna reoccur again. And we all know see, the health sector is very important in our country. Yeah? So what the government don't do, they don't set out a new plan, what they call the National Health Plan, Emergency Plan. Well, what in the National Health Emergency Plan they all about? In case of any major outbreak of diseases, such as measles, you know, any other major outbreak, so they don't put modalities in place for make sure, say, where the outbreak can happen, they know the procedure, where they will follow for make them combat short outbreaks. They put the security in place. For example, where the Ebola crisis may happen some years ago, we've not been get short security apparatus. So it hit me very hard. But now what they don't do, then put some modalities in place for make sure, see, if short crisis happen again, then go know how they go deal with them. Again, we move on for talk about the free primary care service where the former administration under the former president, Ernest Bai Koroma, been come with. When I ask him, he commend indeed the previous administration. But however, he said that sort of facility that now the UK government now be the funder. In other words, Sierra Leone government not been the contribute a dime towards that free primary care service. So, the other challenge again we talk about in terms of the previous administration, he say they always get difficulty to take logistics or drugs to their final destination along the supply chain. In other words, the supply chain management had been poor. By the time where the drugs they come out from Musai and Tekan for Kerango to the final destination, whether a lot of it don't go missing or maybe it gets rusty or something like that. So there was a problem with the supply chain management. But when they ask them under the present administration, so how the free healthcare service, the primary healthcare service, they progress, he actually talks it and they try to get some ownership of that. In other words, they don't want Saleh become completely free. So in 2018, they contribute 20% towards the cost. Currently, I think 2019, they say about 30% contribution in and make towards the ownership of that free healthcare. And by 2020, you know, when they project, say, they will contribute about 50%. So they will get actually 50% ownership of that free healthcare service. Because they believe, say, you know, not to anything free, you know, sometimes a trade-off between free and quality. So they want to get ownership of that facility. And one of the things them also we highlight when a major problem in terms of health facility in a salon is in a storage facility. But you go on for toxic, they say the government to invest, I think, about $11 million package for the construction of storage facilities then. Now the urban areas then, the district areas then, and the children area. And the thing is, you see, storage facility in terms of medicine, I don't know much about medicine, I think say is an important concept, is an important phenomenon in the sense that forget this medicine stored. Forget the medicine and for work at their full capacity. We need a very well ventilated, a well organized facility. We said they will store the medicine here. We along the supply chain and we're able to distribute them to the various hospitals or clinics or whatever. I think that's an important development for the construction of the storage facilities here, now the urban district as well as the chief from level. So one of the other things them way he talk where I like, he say we get for develop that we can do attitude that we for able to run. Not to all them, you know, we go rely on foreign donors them. For say anything we do, we have to rely on international donor supporters them for partners them. And this is exactly what they try for talk. You know, we get for begin for be take ownership. Now make we actually appreciate the effort where the government they take in terms of agriculture, but to all them we dey go import. And this importation, to be a very large extent, then it destroys the economy. All this exchange rate business where they talk about, if we stop, for or we minimize the level at which would they import, they found out, say, they reduce significantly this level of exchange rate we experience at the moment. So he talk about that. He talks, say, we get for the think about manufacturing. Not so all thing, they think, say, we get for the, you know, for the go out, for go get. Now make involved in a lot of training exercise. Try for train we own personnel in our country. Try for develop we own our own brain instead of always relying on overseas training, you know. And the other question, again, where Samuel Wise asks, he asks about accessibility. And this is not a major problem. We know, say, a lot of people and they find difficult in terms of accessing medical facility in other countries, especially the one that we're in the rural area. You know, not to all side we get medical centers, not to all side we get clinics. You know, sometimes by the time you come on at the village, for kind of the urban center or in a big town, you know, it don't cause a disaster, whether the patient end up for die or, you know, the condition become worse. So one of the major challenges that we'll get in that country now in terms of accessibility and affordability. So one of the areas then where the government says and they try for invest in terms of, then they try for make sure, say, they create health centers, train people in the rural areas, you know, nurse system, and make sure they outside and train them, that they then practice, which is important because it become familiar with the area, you know much about the area, then you will likely for able for perform your functions well. I think it's one of the important areas then. And also, you talk about ambulances, the way we then come, a lot of the ambulance system are not being work. I think about currently they get about 173 ambulances the way they work in the country, and they don't deploy about 80 ambulance system at district and chiefdom level. So we have about 80 ambulances to operate at the district level. And in terms of mortality rate, it talks one of the major causes of mortality rate in that country. They say because too many young girls, them under the age, they become pregnant. And what he do, he try for associate this mortality rate in terms of the first lady in agenda, in campaign, when I answer of our girls. They say they like the program because it will help for minimize the rate at which the mortality rate in the country, which is important. And one of the things then we I really like about a statement we make today is this. The fact that it make them quite clear. He said the problem we'll get right now in the country is in a brain drain. What does this mean? In the sense that when they build all the diagnostic centers, yeah, build all the hospitals, yeah, build all the medical facilities, yeah, but would that get for can man? Would that get for can run? Then centers, yeah, then are the problem. Because we not get that personnel, then, you know. For man them people are. Because for operate some of these equipment then you need people then. We get the knowledge, we get the know-how, we get the skills. You know, work out all the technology in the world, in the country, as in rapidly they work on improving the equipment then, building facilities then, but we don't get the know-how. People then we, you know, certain area, certain field, then at the medical side, you need somebody when a specialist we know what team for do, we know how to operate the machinery, and they say, no, we problem. They ask them how we will go about to sort out the challenges here. Well, one of the things then where I think say this it come back to we all brother them, we especially the one that we studied at the medical field, you know, it talks say that for encourage we brothers then. We don't come at the diaspora. Most of whom we can study medicine, you know, when a specialist then a certain field. You know, for make them go back home, you know, for make them go help in the development process in our country. And he did, we need them. But the thing is, for become a trained doctor, it takes years. Although it talks they don't develop a kind of curriculum at the medicine field where training only go on, you know, but at the same time, it takes a while, you know, and where somebody sick, we not go for weight. So in that respect, I think what they try for do here is they try for call indirectly for encourage brothers then for let them go back now in country for let them go help to facilitate and as well as help in the development process and the medical field. For run up, the thing is, you see, the medical, the Ministry of Health, a very sensitive ministry. And I will just highlight a little bit how it connects to some of the other important areas there. You see, the Ministry of the Health sector, it has something to do with human capital development, where the president talked about. Yeah? A sound mind and a sound body. Yeah? If not healthy, you know, we're able to go spend that money. You know, we're able to contribute positively in the community. You know, we're able, we're able to participate in terms of investment. You know, we're able to contribute your capacity towards development in a fall, significantly. So therefore, the health sector, when you think about, the expectancy rate is very low. I think it's less than 50 in Salon. So what you see, so if we get the right medical facilities in place, we say people and put them in a timely manner, you know, and help, I mean, in terms of public health, prevent some of their diseases, yeah, substantially, they contribute to human development, capital human development. And also, when you think about the health sector, it's also about a better issue. These things are all interlinked. Because if you're not healthy, you know, you're difficult. You get for, in their country, yeah, for example, we saw with this, so if you are not healthy, you therefore rely on the state to provide for you. You're not able to work for pay your taxes. You're not able to contribute towards the state. So instead, you become a liability to the state. You see? So all of these issues, health is part of the bread and butter issue, is part of your human capital development. So I so appreciate the man know actually what he can talk. Okay. He got so much experience in the field. So I feel say we hope all them then tear away and the top port and they try for implement them, because as we say, we are more concerned now about the implementation stage. To be honest with you, this government, you know, have said a lot. They have set the stage, you know, they don't talk about a lot of developments then. We only look forward to the implementation stage. Hello. And as we continue for saying, you know, when it comes to implementation, now they always will get the problem. So with a watch and with a listing and with a continue for ask developmental questions for make sure say all them tier where they put that table, all them development here in 1 year's time, in 2 years' time, we will begin bring them to question. We will begin bring them to book. You know, and when they put them here to record, we get for the refer back to them. You know, we don't doubt. You know, we for me, I don't doubt much. I just feel say, you know, we get for ask developmental questions, and then we contribute towards the implementation process. Thank you very much, AAA. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Usman Thori. Thank you for that brilliant way we don't pray the table for we. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Yeah.
Make a call with Tony Ture Jones from Boston. Make we see waiting in one ad on top the table. Yes, Tony, you get the platform, sir.
Yeah, couple from them. And thank you to Usman Thori. We don't see most of the things them we want for mention about. But I want to look at areas them we obviously, I mean, how far we mean our policy we get so much regards for them. I like people that we not to only learn book, but people that were very intelligent in their field of studies. And as somebody we unknown, I don't know for a very long time, is a hard guy. And, you know, but I want to look at areas them, you know, because a presentation was absolutely good. Very, very, very good. And most of them, it tagged them all with a timeline. We, me, at the inside, and they like, we get for the ask question, how far? Because we've seen over the years, nice presentations being done by we authorities or politicians them. But at the end of the day, they will give you timelines and they're not go by the timelines and they. But in presentation was very good. The side way I really, really where I feel impressed now wherein he mentioned about CHOs. My mama, I'm a medical person for over 40 years. And I know a little bit about the medical field. And waiting make at times you get brain drain in them areas and they now because the consideration as they can call them or the period in they give them is very minimal and not attractive for the you get some people that we don't study up to. So, I mean, become a medical doctor, don't spend 6 or 7 years. And at the end of the day, they go give you peanuts. And you see somebody who will be a lawyer within 4 years, not for a college, and can't go to the buy inside 5 years. They drive 20 latest car. And somebody who don't go spend over 6 years, they drive 1990 something or whatever they call. That disparity with it. So basically, I feel sitting there for look at the areas and if they really, really want, because you can get all very nice plans just like how. You know, he mentioned about but if the consideration they pay, and he mentioned about something again, we very impressive. We say the recruitment where they go on and do them by district, wherein if them go bold, they recruit, and where they recruit in Abu, you get for work, then go corner, any ongoing right now. And we're very, very good. And you talk about CHOs, then we call community health officers, them community health officers, then we mention about, say, they don't get license. You see, then they work on the acts now, we in 2022, they time for presenter and a parliament, and they for good for defender. Where in CHOs are community health officers, then we the act, who side doctors, they're not did that much, or probably they know they come all time. Now, them can step in, and you see, then they train them right now for begin do operations. You see how somebody will do operation, then you know, get license. You see, then they walk on down the end. And some time back, then people have me done the shout, them done the alarm, them done the act, because they said me they cry for more benefits, then said me they cry for make them status be improved and recognized, because as it is, they're not that, so they recognize, but they're not much, because they know, I mean, you know, of several reasons that we are not have to take time for explain. And once I will recently, if I comment on the First Lady in page, because me and a friend on Facebook, now this infant mortality rate, where even the last thing, if I mention about under this program, we mean a positive concern, because I don't go on PCMH, I mean, picking delivered. And within a night, I know almost picking and die the next day, not to see them telling me I did their see within hours, you understand? And ambulance services self at some point, I mean, get for give somebody lift self or carry one below mango. And within that process for labor, access for reaching a PCMH, they picking on die. A bone picker don't become stillbirth. So there's so many challenges we, me know, for instance, we are always at the mention about that. Now, the page where I know see politician, they listen when I this info. And he give me a rough figures, or probably we say in 100,000 people, the way they go born, for Salom, the river they wanted to go, the one way they die, now 1,175. Imagine 1,175. If 100,000 women and go for go born, we now 20%. That you understand? And he mentioned about saying the effect for put that figures they don't, then they work on us seriously because of the modalities that they put in place. Because based on this ambulance, we don't deploy in a certain place. We Usman Soli mentioned about we don't deploy already 80 out of the 173 because they inherit 180 or so or something. And ain't no say the ambulance, there be more than 400, so missing. That tells you the mindset of Sierra Leoneans. And we all see how many ambulances they do in the Ebola. For like they only inherit 200 out of 400 and something way in an inventory. So that tells you that, I mean, so that alone and the deployment of ambulance is a good thing because I've witnessed several times where there are a great challenge and the way with people than they face. Then you talk about specialist maternal services where they get now during way. I mean, me and because we like picking them so much, I'm concerned about picking more than even when they say I answer for our guys because you care for at that young age, you care for cater for them. You understand? If we're not able to cater for them, we will say total quality management. If you're not able to manage baby at that age, we in brain, because if you mention about I'll count that side away. If you born picking, you face challenges at that infant stage, again for affecting cognitive power. How they learn books from beginning and go become full, whether it was autistic or this or that. And most of them at that stage and the way them be deprived. We probably oxygen during the childbirth, there's a delay in oxygen or oxygen begin go down, it also affects the brain because we all know say oxygen will go to your brain and they help to keep you functioning and make you think I'm well. And it mentions say then they try for doing a cancer center, we diagnostic center we go there in a salon. We are really be impressed because why is Mongo asking somebody go spend $400-$500 go Ghana, therefore just go do a test because $100. So imagine the disparity there. If you spend more than what you go do. And he mentioned about me and one person we're very concerned over cancer and diabetes way because at some point before my mommy did I and my sister were diagnosed of diabetes way. I know exactly how it turned like way. I mean the pain up so this now in May, April that they talk about way for do that finger stick test they pay 15,000 leons. I got to a point, my mom get history of diabetes, I go buy the machine. You understand? Because every time they can, they go to the normal. Within 12 hours, we go for a checker every 2 hours. That which means they go for a checker 6 times. They pay 15,000 you know, every and the money. I even ask them for receipts. They tell them they can't vex the nurse and they vex for me back. Say, well, if you continue for the ask for receipts, they go to the color, then go vex. So they go to say, but what side this money they go? Why they pay 15,000 every 2 hours when they can't check my blood sugar? You understand? So we and the rate of two Sierra Leoneans in the doubt of diabetes. It's very alarming. Quick, do not cut foot. Abraham, you know, me cousin will just die away. Therefore, cutting foot Monday, the poor lads make he die Saturday. You understand? The rate at which way diabetes, they kill people in a salon and cancer. It's very alarming. You know, see diabetes people, and they live now, then they drink, then they chill, and they enjoy, then they this, now the US now. We, it's like, you way with the fee say, if we get, we need forget. And the good thing we had to look at when we get so much invest in that area, they bring needed foreign exchange what we need. Where we cry for, say, we're not the exports. We're not the exports. We're just the imports. No more. What it go boil down to? We see the influx of Sierra Leonean going to Ghana. Do you know how many thousands of dollars Sierra Leoneans, the way they go to Ghana, they go with? For go do some of them tests then they for medical condition. If we self get them good laboratories then they in a Sierra Leone Diagnostic Center, well, state of the art, equipment, you know what it means like? People from Guinea, people from Liberia, people from other countries that were neighbor. We just like our people in the own Ghana. You understand? More money will they come. We only see, you mentioned about Mabese yesterday. There was a time people in the come out Guinea, they come Mabese and Alosa. People then they come over center, UMC for eye operation. If we can build that base there, if we can build, because when they talk about, you talk about your economy, if you have to grow your GDP, health system is number one. There is no foreign companies when they do their due diligence, when they do their background check, they have to look at all them things then. If expatriates, if foreign workers then sick, who's hospital? If we not get hospital, then we get qualified personnel. We reiterate so many times about personnel, train personnel, then what will not get? Because you, after six years, we don't spend medical school, you get to go to 3 years, you get to go specialize another 3 years. If we don't have those people, definitely some of their companies, and they go, you know how much it takes for you get an air ambulance for go salon? From Ghana to Sierra Leone, for get an air ambulance, it's over $15,000. You understand? Oh, $50,000, in fact. So when you look at that area, the way they look at, just the car, they talk about power. Mind you, those things, they never move without power. Because if you want to get an hospital, where state of the art and everything, all inside the hospital, we can forget power. So now the sequence and the way they move. If we get we hospital them well-equipped, me man, then come on sickness, we need to see the kill people in a salon, me man. Now it could be the thing of the past. The life expectancy rate in a salon, it could be far improved. Where the life expectancy rate for a young man, Nasalon, now if you reach 50, it's 47 years. For a young man, if you pass 47, a young man, Nasalon, we know you tell what thank you. Just because we get food. We food are organic. Organic food. These are not chemical food. These are not processed food. These are organic food. But common sickness and where they catch people there, they kill people there, easy one, because with medical condition. You talk about storage, we're very important. The last time I talked now, so, but then they are not going to put much in a cup, as then Kuren can see. Then they pay so many money to Basun, when I'm a Lebanese man, for storage for people medical, free medical medication, over $500,000 a year. Go now that storage day. Naturally talk about the temperature. Medicine therefore the under a better cooling temperature. Mama, if you go another study, the medicine is so dust. If you knock the box, then so dust pack pan. If na lad, let person go check them medical study and they within a free talk. No proper cooling. And those medication, and they take them, carry them, go upline, go give we people them. And we people them back, they take them. Where the medicine go, they not there under the proper atmosphere. How you feel say it go effectively cure people them? So many challenges. Any presentation was really perfect. It hit everything where I go for look at. Then another area I want to talk about where we get good health records. Even with education system, where he mentioned about talk about primary, talk about secondary health care and this and that. We go get foreign students that will go to come, man. Foreign students and go to come for study and this and that. And it was so many things that will be improved, man, because I mean, if they're sick, they not say we got all those facilities. We will not say we colleges, then they train people, they want anything, and people they scout for university all over in Africa for suicide. That's a cheap and effective, and then they deliver good services. So I'm just not asking the show, but his presentation was very good, and the infant mortality rates were erased as a concern. We at least areas that we now one we say teenage pregnancy now one way they cause them. At least the sensitization still there for gone. You know? I mean I'm your take Randy. Thanks so much for having me. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, Tony Ture Jones. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Well, we don't get Tony, and we also we don't get Usman Tolley. Make we go na salon, make we bring Bokari Vandi from Sierra Leone. Yes, Bokari, you get the platform. Tell we small about the work of the CHOs them na salon.
Okay, good evening, Sierra Leone, and good evening, Sierra Network. I'm happy this night for me to give me the opportunity for me to talk to the country as a whole on the basis of community health officers, because any country where they're on the path of development, we know say the medical doctors them, now we onboard them. But if you want for improve on the medical feed, you get a lot for do, because the one that when at the middle man them, you almost always get for draw them whether they in line with voting, they keep up to the good work of the country. I want to use this opportunity for tell Professor Riri thank you, because like I say, we health system the week and we see how it be exposed during the Ebola time. Upon the assumption of office last year, I don't do a lot for make salon health system day on a people we want for make a day. And if we want for make a day on that peak, remember I share one video with Sierra Network about 30 minutes or 1 hour ago. If you go through that video, India or the Middle East Africans and Asian, the middle man, they did not empower them so much so that them people, yeah, because now the first line people, them now rural place them. You go na Kubola, you come where go Kailam, Daru, you come where go Kabbala, all the far to rich areas, and now them people are sitting on the health centers there. If them people are done there in practice from 1988 or so up to date, they're not licensing them, then this not fear on the part of them CHOs there. Because as a responsible government, somebody no go there, they go check my sister, my mama, my papa, and belle. Then up to date, you not try for license. You can recall in 2017, we get a strike where they put down and to say they need for the license. The then minister be take and play and not ever take them serious. So may they also use this opportunity to plead to Professor Ri, you know, overdue from the CHOs, and then in this country, the practice as CHOs, they do the work the way we know say is very important. All over now this country, from Connaught down to the least CHC where they don't open yesterday, CHOs and they in this country. Yeah, they do this like way it is tough. Yeah, they do surgeries and now way it help for save with mama their life, with sister their life. We know, like you say, Boku of we brothers and sisters and where they train as doctor, because of the poor condition in the country, everybody look for greener pasture. Nobody no go once for they don't go they come as 8 years, they come on the housemanship 2 years, may I say 9, 10 years, a day that they can't get them waiting. You not gonna be happy with. Instead, we'll look for which side it will left. We never come to there. Any other side, we will go get. I'm waiting. It will be satisfied with. But here we are, which we brothers then. As it is, you come here now. You go to the far, to rich area. Then they at all times and ready for save life. So for make the minister say, they on the pipeline for many CHOs they get licensed. They don't overdue. The CHOs are supposed to get their license now. And in as much as they pay more attention to commerce, I will also want to pay, take this opportunity. That we don't take the course to Jala University, the under Jala University. May they also pay attention to Jala University because we want quality in our healthcare system. So if they pay attention to all other sides, the nurses, we don't do very something very good. Where by one, they stop, they don't make time when they train SCCHNs then because they want for their quality. So all same goes to all KEDA. If only the minister could take up this now, because the bill, we can recall, they don't go parliament, parliament ratify them, but then the former minister be advised, former president Romano for sign them and say the CHOs for go into Allied Health Board. But then, if you go in search of all Allied Health Board na the world, this na board way that they form, like now, you get the Sierra Leone Medical and Dental Council. I'm not in any way try for compare them to CHOs. Now, just an example, you get the Nurses Council. You can put them one there all together and call them Allied Health Council. But a CHO done there from 1988 to date, they not get a board. Then you come for can put them into Allied Health Board. We get them challenges here. We get people then when they claim for BCHO's jobs because the CHO by then not be getting any representative in the ministry. Okay, if you tell the former government, thank you, by 2012, they'll be able to give the CHOs and the Office of the Chief Community Health Officer, which of course, that don't care for create a room where each and every CHO where the government could try for employ the most pass through that office. But now we stand
okay,
with that.
I want all you and a small. So right now, let us say for the last 5 years, because you give it for 2012 where they don't create that particular office. Mm-hmm. But for the last 5 years, we get any people and we graduate newly as CHOs then at the country?
Of course. Every year, CHOs and they graduate.
So we they talk about the one them way beyond, we not certified. Now they need certification, right?
Now we they talk about the one that will be done graduate from 1988 to date, with some still they practice. the need for be licensing.
Okay.
Because you get some NGOs and when they come to this country, we want for employee CHOs. Someday, like the MSF, you go MSF all over Nassau, 80% of the clinicians and are CHOs. Other NGOs them also are CHOs. Because some can understand that they even ask why we not get licensing. But then it has trending how for explain to them why CHOs are not licensed from
so make we understand this well. After they graduate, they need a license, right?
Yeah, just like we you don't come on medical school as a doctor, you don't go when you come graduate and come as a doctor, you before you do your housemanship, they give you temporary license as when you do housemanship, after you 2 years housemanship, you're going in for your permanent license. So just like the nurses, the pharmacists, and the doctors, they get license for practice in the country. Now that's the CHOs have done the cry for from the past 30 years or so now.
So waiting na be the lapses because if all the other one in the way you name after that then go through the housemanship then they are well equipped with the the license. So waiting happen with the CHOs them?
Okay, like I say, this na the middleman them between the other cadres, the doctors and the other cadres, and any side with doctor, not the first person we go on for contacts and the CHOs. And the meaning of CHO, like my brother be just saying, are community health officers. Then, and as community health officers in training or even after training, you get a lot of work where they do, you get a clinical work where you get for do, you get for doing public health. It can be very disheartening way we say this throughout Ebola. We get more CHOs and we die more than doctors. But then, whenever they, in this country, that they say anything but medicine business, they will just say the doctor, the nurses, and the other health workers. And CHOs and not any other health workers. And these are community health officers. And from time immemorial, we parliament, nobody don't thought and fit say, them people have to be licensed for hope. We will tell the last parliament thank you because they be see and say it needful and somebody nobody go take name from a pinup and a mama, a pinup and a sister, but make a save in life in all license. That they just try for tell we say the policy of himself not secure. So they be able to ratify a bill we entitled to the Community Health Practitioner Act 2017. They go through parliament, parliament ratify and on May 11, 2017, I can still record that they did. Then take the bill, the clerk, the sign and take her to president. But Dr. Abubakar Fufana, the then Minister of Health, may not know if now grudge or bad that it gets for CHOs and the advice former President Kumano for sign that bill. What's not the reason we get? He said because if they get bored because of economic value. But then people really add to the economic value of Sierra Leone. Then people really help to for increase on but putting us alone. Then people are going to be the forerunners and during the time of Ebola. But people die as CHOs during the time of Ebola, but they don't ever recognize them because I don't know which thing they hold against them. So, President, be you take up office, he assure this country, say, in a new direction. And if the new direction will go with each and every one of the ministers, then. And the last 2018 activities where Professor Uri Bipunado, if you go through that in the civil side, it talk about the Community Health Act. But we don't know down the line what thing they happen because it directly assures them, say, by 2018 before it is done, then people will get an act and they will be licensed just like it talk and during commerce and licensing period. That was that's in 2018. See. Now, as a ministry, we will try by all means CHOs and we will be licensing them, but we don't know what to hold in those. Because we know say, today, that did not take us to Parliament. The Parliament of Sierra Leone ready for ratifying because CHOs and they win a parliamentarians. We get three CHOs and win a parliamentarians, and And even at the parliament, if the one, if any emergency something happened, would have forced the rush to for take care of the CHOs and the get parliament CHCs. We have two CHOs and the cover. So I don't really know who side the problem in our country.
Okay.
Because
You say last year, 2018, they don't give promises, yeah. Then say then they work on them. And now, this as yeah. recent as today, they don't talk the same mm-hmm. thing back. So I think say we don't get knowledge of that, and we self go the open eye and throw a word in that area. They say these people, they need for be licensing, yes, because of with all the thing that we say, instead of acknowledge that with what thing they do, but they need for be licensing. Before you go, what thing are the latest on the PIN code and the recently graduated nurse them? You get any idea?
Well, I don't say that they give PIN codes out to nurses, CHOs, and every other kid in the country. According to them, promise they make, I don't know how many they don't give now, they be say they will give about 1,000 health workers. I know of recent say that they give PIN codes because I get a sister when I'm a nurse, they can maybe they full time there from both for like 3 days where you come for process and PIN codes. Then they don't try, you increase on the manpower, you increase on, you develop the facilities and whether they use. That's all they don't try.
Okay, so let me just use this person we use as an example. So for mm-hmm. the PIN code, it be get for left book and a free tongue.
Yeah.
So that's not the happen. Who's are you there?
Well, because waiting, he can tell me that we go interview them now. Bo, they do all things now. Bo, they. But when they tell us, say, when our appointment letter already, you know, salon, we get one big problem where they affect we as a country. Because of this decentralization, everything, if you not come down to free time, it not go happen. Even where they don't give you with sisters and with brothers and appointments, letters, you go for leave the far end where you did. You come free time, you go HRMO, you go take your appointment letter, you go for big worker from NACRAM, go Ministry of Health and you building. All that process, it come from Monday, not complete until like Wednesday. Like even in Nasit, because it not be done the work for any government, it be only get for go back, take the Nasit from field and they say, okay, say Nabo, it was not Nabo. So like for this month, it don't get the PIN code, but if you don't get Nasit, obviously government not they pay you. So you know your salary this month. Pass a go for whatever process and Nabo. So that's now another big problem for we because remember, you don't go, I gladly, I appreciate that. First time, we know, say, they call the interview in our free time. But this time, they go meet them at the district, they interview them there. But when the appointment letter come on, you get for come to free time, can HRMO, can do all them processes there. So that's definitely another challenge for we brothers and sisters. And some man, not even they will sign it to talk, they adult if some man don't can take in letters because like, I mean, see on social media now, call them. Say, madam, they be there interview now. See, see, they say appointment letters, they don't, they out now for owner. So they get for travel and can't take an appointment letter, begin do now the process because involving you get for go, NACRAM, go take certificate of identification, you get for go do medical now. Corners, you come on there, you go, you building, let's say, whether your documents, they will give you, you get for go. Now, you, if now you chief nursing officer, get for sign, or you chief community health officer, or the chief medical officer, and they get for sign, then you come back, now HRMO, or such of that. So, morning time, man, you go, I drop them off, then you go.
Okay, what thing will be your last word for me, could left you for go?
Okay, my last word, one. I really want to talk on teenage pregnancy because up to date, we don't both say we health system not improve, but up to date, salon still in at the top, say we maternal and mortality rate, we still stand there. We, those days when we go to school, we get family health, but now, we don't get anything like that on the curriculum. Then, what thing I would like for say to Professor Ori and the Ministry of Basic and Senior Secondary School, they need for take this back to the curriculum because we with sisters them and we mama them really need for know how they go for plan themselves. Mama of the country, when the first lady has excellence in Dan Fatima Jabibio, don't they do well? But you go preach all this, if waiting at the underlying cause, we're not able to solve them, we're not able to prevent resistors them. You can stop, tell somebody, say, teenage pregnancy, this, that. But the main cause of teenage pregnancy, then people are, we need for make sure, say, the contraceptives, them where they available now, and the different health facilities, them. DFID presently, they into a project, when are saving life, is two projects, where they implement with partners, them, where restless development, Maristope, Guam, concern worldwide, CAM agents, then people are defeat the work with them. And family planning and one party kids in a way defeat this sponsor person in the country. We they talk to the ministries and may they include back with adult in health education back into the curriculums and for develop with sisters and with brothers their mind.
Just a quick one, yeah, Bokai. So okay. That FLE, family life education, you know, in the school curriculum anymore.
I know they because I know they did. That's not thing I will do with school curriculum again. No, no, if time they will get for put on there because it really challenging. Because if family life education be still inside the curriculum, I don't see no reason why a whole parliament for them go rectify the safe abortion bill, then people will grab and stop say they're not for. Presidents not for sign them. Yeah, people going to look at them from the religious view and other things. But as it is, my brother, like how they talk to you, the amount of illegal abortions and where they happen in the country, then religious leaders, there, you go get some imams, some pastors, who go tell you, say, hey, my man, I don't go give me a leg, I speak to, I don't want me woman, no. Then they preach to the president not sign them, but they do them secretly. So it's not a big deal, but safe abortion did.
Yeah, you be want to give me one example just now, yeah. Carry on.
One example, why be one gina just I get my small sister, a BD SS1. At one point in time, I travel, I go home, and I come home say 8 o'clock. Wake up, I put her on because the thing way I don't learn now salon. One thing, when we sisters and go bad, we they take them for whip them. And when you take her for whip them, the next thing way they come with, na belly. So I put her down, I talk to her as a small one. Say this now the reality of life. This now you get for them. The next thing where I do, some people can say, okay, where you go tell somebody for go take family planning, you did like try for like put them into prostitution. But I want a better life for them. I want a better thing for them. I tell them, oh, what's not the necessary thing? I take them, I carry on one of the health facilities, then they go for go get them family planning, where like now be the captive man, whether they call the implants for 5 years. Now, and they prepare for go university. If only at that moment, so I be go away, come on, I come, I be just bash at them, tell them, say this, that, and that they are forget, but I continue for go. The next moment, we come with belly. Obviously, they don't turn a burden on we because I don't go want to see them in the streets in the street, I don't go help them. Yourself, not go want to see his sister in the streets, I don't want to be in the street, you don't go help them, of course. So I be able to talk to her, I go take the family plan and see the advice. So I can use that as a testimony now to talk and say, okay, my brother, we make I take this. So up to this, I'm able to get better because I don't prevent myself from me and born picking the 10-1-1 time. Now I go to university. So we want for Mary sisters then be at the helm of Tina Salon. Everybody want, hey, woman, they need them, but we get a lot for of things for do for we sisters, and because if only we make them say some things, we take and say we take for take them by the horn, say we go for take the bull by the horn, say this where we encourage we sisters and for do one, because like I say, these religious leaders will come now, we air and stay within the one for say when they left, they get within against, they get for go do. Yeah, nah, but me not care about that. More we just accept things in the right way. We not the same more follow the Western world in anything. We go for maintain we culture, but in as much as we maintain we culture, we want for beef up the system. Say the next time we go come in a salon for talk, may we minister of health be woman, may we minister of this be woman, because we know say the more woman, the more we get in the global stage, the more we be able for push we self go before.
Okay.
But if we continue for draw with sisters, then may they not do what they're supposed to do. We allow small ones, then if somebody don't start my business, may I just say this before I leave, don't start my business. No amount of advice, not the way they tell this somebody, we go listen to you. When Uma wants something, for may it get them. Whatever thing it takes for Mela Uma get them, they get them. True or false?
That's true.
Yeah, so if Uma don't go with young one, with small one, they don't go into sexual activities, then you can't try for can't stop them. The next moment, na mele you the same it. So my advice to with parents them, not say if you go tell you picking for go take family planning, you need to take her into position. You the help for like push you picking far away from mele. Teenage pregnancy, we first lady will try, we'll do him best, hands off our girls. Yeah, teenage pregnancy after 18 okay. years.
Okay, Bokari, what you go do here? Yeah? I think once every month, I go to car with you, make we can talk about the health talk and how certain things then they involve, evolve in the area where you did. Thank you very much for your time, yeah?
Yeah, welcome, and thanks for having me.
All right, thank you, Bokari Vandy.
Yeah.
That's na Bokari Vandy. I believe say you don't listen to everything what he say. From Usman Tolly to Tony, then we come to Bokari. More for Bokari because he didn't have the ground, he didn't have the health field, he don't able for enlighten we how things then they work there. We know say naya, we don't talk about decentralization. Just imagine you day whatever partner the provinces where you day. Now social media. Yes, okay, you go say that they fine, but because we post in system now the country not correct. Because if you correct by right, Ministry of Health and Sanitation where they don't hire them people in there, then for post the letters then today. Any kind of way, if even self na the headquarters, then the district headquarters, they outside and go interview them, then post their letters, then they want and they try for list with the people. We need for try for fix things them in place. We really need for try for fix things them in place. Okay, now you don't get say yes, they don't hire you. You get for left usa you day, come all the way in a free tongue. Free tongue, you take almost this day, pass open, don't open, don't open. No, the process is not even simple. You hear I explain them. The process is not even simple. After all that hustling day and bustling, you get for go back, go, you dey feel form with nasit na free tongue, but you dey go back up, usa you come out, go snap with nasit day. Eh? You can imagine? Okay. Why make them stop the family life education na the school curriculum? Because that one day, na other one way for help. Now the first lady in campaign are hands of our girls. So not for just go na them big field and the campaign and whatnot. Where you did it, you did it. Where you don't come body, you don't come body. But family life education, all I want the hands of your girls, aunts, this or whatever, all for come inside. If I just be a revised syllabus now, then for be able for you say, okay, now this now waiting we want for tackle, just chuka inside the family life education. But we just learn say family life education in order again. So are you surprised? With all waiting they unfold in the side of the boy picking them and also the side of the girl picking them. Eh? Yes, the minister talk about teenage pregnancy. He talk them way now they make the infant mortality rate the high. Picking born picking. We medical system not good, then picking they go get belé. So these are the type of things them where we try for pinpoint on. As you smantle in our Facebook, they say it's a poverty na the major cause for teenage pregnancy na saloon. It asks question. He say right or wrong. And George Camara say, then they also fail for realize, say, then act here they be driven by hormones. Where person not go able for control. He talk about the health care providers them, the family members them, the parents them, they for educate them, picking them on sex education. He said, but people and things say na taboo for talk to picking about sex before puberty. He said the girl picking their need for know and for learn about the menstrual cycles, advising them, waiting for do, waiting not for do, and also about unprotected sex. And even the boy picking them for teach them how for be manly enough for do the right thing and also how for use condom. But when you come to we own aspects, now we own country, we know say then kind talk here na talk the way can always difficult to forget. But let we not be carried away. Because waiting Boka we tell we say this thing about the CHOs them. The minister, Dr. Alpha Wui, he talk him last year. Say before last year done, then go down, get the license. Now he don't talk him back. So these are the things that we're trying to say here. We no want for just the repeat. When you talk something, you need for follow up and do. If you don't talk last year, you don't promise last year, then 2019, towards the end of 2019, you still promise the same promise. Then where are we? I'd open the phone line for a short while. Yes, caller, you're live on air. Your name and who's the call from?
Hello, this is Janet Matamusa. I call from the United Kingdom.
Yes, Janet, you get a platform.
Yes, you know, contraceptive conversation now with Konski, it not go easy. Because, I mean, I'm on VOS every week. There's an education program. We talk about the media, the schools, government, you know, for begin talk about contraceptives and to the young girls. Then I was a young girl myself. I must say by 14, 15, 16, hormones are all over the place. Therefore, involve parents them for hold this conversation. They get in small clinic them. We go to help them young girl they are so for the go take them contraceptive medication. You can keep them very quiet. You cannot deny the act that the fact that age the way woman they reach where man play by the cam and the baba they say they put stress but we were small. You know, so this a two-way street. We go for talk to get the parents them and the schools them forget this conversation. It's an open conversation. And I think, say, the media also for drive this conversation. It's not that we are encouraging them to be loose because the cultural practices in Africa, now in the whole way back, you know, they say, oh, no one can make sex free for the pekine, made them loose. That's not the point. The point is this happening. They are having sex, period. How can we stop them from having children when they are children themselves? These are babies having babies. In the Western world, who's are we there? I bump two girls picking in this country. Yeah. By the time they're 15, 16, I put them down. I tell them, hey, you have a future ahead. When I bobby the old ones happen on a chest now, you must feel something like you body. I need you to begin to talk openly to me and contraceptive like you know you're your doctor, also me. You're your doctor, when I go arrange and day and blah, blah, blah. And it worked, you know? So that then can't hear so one a salon, comrade for be open with them, picking them. You know? Let's begin to have a conversation with mothers, get parental involvement with them, picking them. Mama and daughter, put them down and advise them. No, could not shame again. The cultural practice not allow some of them to hear for say, well, mama, they go talk to him, picking, but not having sex. The time has come. The time has come when we need to do these things because otherwise, when you look with now right now, we country, then are caught, ECOWAS caught because they don't want to include pregnant girls into mainstream education. How do we stop our girls from being pregnant while at school? Contraceptive is the answer. Thank you very much for having me.
And before
me.
I left you for good, Janet, what do you think about stopping the family life education subject now the school curriculum?
They're not for stop them. They're for still carry them. They're for still carry them on. That they educate the picking them. They understand what it means about family planning. You know, they're for carry them because they're educating them. That they ain't going to make some girl picking go say, I can't abstain. Or I go tell my boyfriend, say, use a condom. Or we go on the pill. This is school girls for carry them. They do it out here for educate the girls them. You know, so you know when you're ready, you can refuse certain things. You can discuss certain things. I feel, say, government carry on that program there at the schools them. All schools then for carry them on. You know, even when they're at universities, you know, some man they talk openly about sex, let alone contraceptive. You know, so if the schools then begin, they continue for carry the program, I think to say it could be effective. It could make them take decisions then where we're not going to affect them in the long run by either abstaining or taking contraceptives, having conversations, we're going to reshape their life and understanding. I was a girl myself. I was 19 when I left school because I don't go to school early, you know. But I had a child. In those days, you can't even talk to your mom about a baby, you know. But that not stop me for go on and read law at university in England. But we don't want, not everybody get locked for get that kind of a family day. But we are saying, let the schools get it, continue the program for make with girls them protect themselves. I mean, I think it's the best thing to do.
Thank you very much, Janet. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, caller, you're live on air. Your name and who's the call from?
Patricia Vande from Buffalo, New York.
Yes, Patricia, you get the platform.
I'm so happy for this program. So today, where you bring time to pray. It feel like where the other sister don't talk come. That family life education. Yes, doing with time. As a teenager, I've been there salon. They go school. Been there. But they, you know, when they get the understanding, self, what they're about. Because they get a limitation, what did they tell you? Because, like where the other caller, them, you know, say, if you call picking and tell about sex, then they take and say, you know, for do that, like, not crime, you don't commit. And when they teach them, they know they open them. Like, so say, if you come back now, it will be different because. Everybody here they open now. But before, it been that day. But they not been a teacher the way it's supposed to be. I don't know if somebody they were in the 80s, where they go to school, they will talk about that. But we just don't know and say, oh, family life education. Or not even know what they're about, sir. Because they know they expose that to you for making you know what they're about. Then, too. Where that guy been? They talk about for men and women. I don't know pin ban and then they gina salon. Why they not they make like I don't know like well then I ask. So if you take your exam, like you not see feel. You know need for go for all them process and then made them put in place that once you don't take you state exam, you don't pass them. Then they for made them post you license and you address or whatever. Where you want for me, then send them to you, then send them to you. Then people, then they left all the way outside, then they go struggle in a free town back for go make them go there, then pin. You know, I don't think say it makes sense because if people, then I understand say schools, and they're all over now. It's forcing them like Connor, Kenima, go and take their exam. I think so, then Kindede, for me, then get them nursing license. For most of them, they then where they go for take that time they take for go back na free town for made them get time. And I think say we go for they talk about that a lot for na salon for me things get changed because then they talk things then they know they do them. Now for me they talk today everybody feel happy about it. Then it just go under the carpet or forget about them. And if they talk about things every day, we put them into action, development go come. But for the talk, we know they do it. It's like, what in the need for talk? Sometimes they make okay, listen, okay, say, oh, even this world they talk on a Sega network. When you pass on the message, what did they do to the things then? Then they put them into use, or then just they just listen and just throw them out there, then forget about them. You see? Like that, other sister they talk, say, yes. You know, we'll therefore be open up to picking them. Even me, I didn't have so. Every day, my niece and nephew is the way they're in a salon. I explain to them about sex. If you do it this time, that's something that will happen to you. And I want to know Africa say, back where na they are the ego also within a ego see school kid here and company student they get them talking and they but in teacher no go mistake for say I want you for girlfriend but Africa that na common thing they big man say go see small picking where in picking say full person but once he want use that picking day he go abuse her you know care about her. But if they open up for tell the picking and say, oh, you get for use, you contract, not done, go for checkup, may take your medication, you know, go get sex, or you know, you tell your boyfriend, say, no, use condom. Explain to him. And when they say HIV, but not get mine for tell person, say, oh, no, before I have sex with you, log made a test before, last, see what happened to you. Because some people know they talk to them, that they hide them. Then they go and spread sick all over the place. So I think say they will, something and they will go forget about this taboo business. For they talk so if he talk this in the land picking, no. If he nowadays he tell picking thing, he see him, he tell him the truth. If he do this, that will happen. Then go listen. Like me say what they talk now. So me now one of the victims back in the salon where it be happen to we. So man go beat you if he won't pass you, but he wants to abuse you. Because you're innocent and you can't do something, so you know it makes you feel safe for talk. Well, you're not fine. So I think say okay for they talk about make all my eyes open wide for know what they're up to. Now that's not my own contribution for today.
Thank you very much, Patricia Vandy. Thank you. Yes, call ID live on here. You name and who's I call from?
Me now who's friend? Call from Manchester, sir.
Yes, who's friend? You get the platform.
I just want for buttress within brother Bokari been try for talk about him being a community health officer. I can remember years back in 1987 to 1988, then Germans they began open this school they call paramedical. It been there na the highway, na bo they call New London that area there. They open them for train community health officers. So if I be almost tempted for good, 1 year, well, I miss for good in Jala. So, but it can't happen where they train that thing by turn, then they dispatch them, then they get a Honda after that, then dispatch them at the community. But years go on and go on and go on, but not just know now again, it just disappear. Where then can now then open them to like a school, a college way now in Jala something. Then branch and back with something else. We then begin to do nursing day. Then begin to do all that different thing. We don't even know if they even do this again, community health work. But that was a very good initiative we then bring. Remember in 1987, just 1 year or 2 years before the Civil War outbreak. But I don't know how that one disappear. But the mistake where I say government did they do, the power government or whoever they beyond they govern, now things that would they come, would they not they look far for say dentia and I think that we in the future we they build them for let we go able for go before. Even now would they introduce this idea of changing that school of medical school. If them if we don't get foundation, they expand that place there. Instead of them go put the many polytechnical things there. Then if we don't open another place for that separate one, then they build that thing, they big. Then we they train community health officers and the one know. Because they're full of boys and I'll be there the same host. The year we get on that if he tempt me for love, go even do the community health officer. Oh, but me that even just they divert my attention to something else. But the idea is here that whenever something they come, then they just take and say, it did it. Look, just like just did it no more. We know they try for know what we able for do for push and let it go grow, let it go develop. But if that thing day they be developed that thing day, it before don't be a very, very good initiative. And look at the SCCH and then back. The SCCH and then as you see, now state enrolled community health nurses. Then they get SRN. When a state registered nurse, wouldn't they say staff nurse? So therefore don't go to the hospital. The SECH and then before don't make another course, we are in the train support worker, we're a healthcare assistant, when they help the state registered nurse, the owner staff nurse. Then the SECH then they left them at the community because that was the primary aim of SECHN nurses there. So then before the shadow, like the community officers there, then doctors, they do other things in the community. But then just not being the try for direct them, say, we're not SECHN them, we're meant for be na the community. Because what they do in a placement, the community, then they send them, na then different primary health care, they send them a McKinney, they get one, they send them a bow, they want other place. I don't know how they call it after that place, and get not the school. But they are meant for the community. But it just don't diminish gradually. Now when they come on, now inside hospital straight away. But they are SECHN. Now the name in principle, but in practice, they are coming out as just nurses when they can't help now the wards there. And when you go now the wards, now then they come very frequently now the wards. Why go work a once in a corner? This time will be good day. Now they mix day, then they sit down in the place of the staff nurse. The staff nurse there, then they now the other new hospital there where they don't open. Now they all don't go work. They know they try for say the staff knows that for daily, let the treatment go well. Because on drugs and they, now drugs they want to control drugs, we either get people there for tinapia sign and give the patient. Then you come back out again, then they treat the nurse there. Look how nurses and they come out today. When they come out, one thing when they introduce, we don't see one thing. Every nurse, when they begin the training, you're supposed to get hepatitis B vaccine. Because when they go now the ward, you get things the way they go meet up. You know, they get protection from the liquids or from other things the way they charge fluids. They contract this is what they say, hepatitis B. Because the C now from then needles and body B, now for the nurses, and then picking the way they born new one there. Therefore, make a free to them for 3 doses, where they forgive the nurses there. When then they undergo training, government for think about that back when they bring drugs in. Then therefore think about again how they go able for the give small thing to the nurses and when they undergo training. Let them see if they will minimize some of these nurses. School they would not open, then to boku, so that they will just concentrate on few where they go train, where they worthwhile. Then important, then we able for do what in they able for do. Now that side, you know, mommy go able for contribute for tonight. But let them think of some of the things we they bring. Let them learn for expand them instead of them just the say let it did it. We forget better. Salon before don't be booming in health. If no more than TRF after all they do, then before they do them, let them think about it. Thank you very much for giving the platform.
Thank you very much. Usfren, thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you, bless you.
Yes, caller, you're live on here. Your name and who's the call from?
Hi, good evening. This is Aisatu from New York.
Yes, Aisatu. What's in your own contribution?
Well, you know, I listened to the interview initially, and which was, you know, some of them were very good news. You know, we really do hope for things like that to happen. Now Sierra Leone, because I want to say we get a lot of nurses them with Sierra Leoneans and with the live overseas. We all look forward to a better health centers. Maybe one day we all could go back and give back to the community or to society as a whole in Sierra Leone. But, you know, sometimes it's just so hard. You know, you don't go to school now for like just left. You know, what you do here and go to Freetown. You can do that in a humanitarian help, you know, but then for go sit on the, and it's like the training we get now is not compared to the training within the given at Freetown. So that is maybe not a factor, but maybe once we get a well-developed health facilities, you know, many of us, you know, probably will decide for go there because we do have registered nurses, nurse practitioners, you know, then they actually act like almost what the physician they do, but they just train differently. Then they will see their own patients, prescribe medications and so forth. So those, that's one thing in terms of people that wait for them for encourage for go back to the homeland and for work there because yes, getting all these equipment, these high-tech, you know, equipment, if you're not getting the right people then for work day, it's going to be like, you know, waste you know, and when they say highlight health services, so that includes like the radiology tech, that includes the registered nurses, LPNs, you know, so there, and anybody who really work now the health department, we have to physician. Then coming to like educating young ones about, you know, contraceptives, you know, protection, that's very important. Now something where you for do, yes, when the skin and the around then, you know, like middle school or let's say fifth and sixth grade, you for have that discussion with the girl about, you know, her menstrual cycle. Also the boys, you know, they would become, you know, like puberty, you know, there's average. So everybody may, some of them are early, some of them are late. So it depends, but we should not be afraid to have that discussion with them. And also the family practice providers, where the Pekin County in a hospital, it's important that you have that conversation with the Pekin, the boy or the girl, about how to protect themselves, you know, and with way they do their time today, I think, you know, it's highly recommended that you do, you know, with the child alone or with the adolescent alone by themselves. Why? Because not standing at any own privacy, right? So confidentiality is very important to them because they don't want to know what thing, you know, let them parent them know what thing they do out there. You know, so even if they get boyfriend then and they do things then, they don't want to let them parent know. So these are things that you want to have the conversation with the boys and say, you know, you have to use a condom. And then, you know, the girls, you know, you may want to consider, you know, contraceptives, whether it's oral, you know, whether it's injection, if you already sexually active. Even if they're not sexually active, if they already have their menstrual cycle, you want to have that discussion. Because I'm sure we all want our children to go to school, you know, and actually, you know, become independent, not become dependent, right? So I believe, you know, we all should be taking that initiative. I know the culture, I know the permit in terms of certain things that we want to discuss with the kingdom, but I think we're in the 21st century now. Things should be different.
So, all right. Thank you very much. Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
Ibu?
Hello?
Yes, caller, you're live on your name and side call from?
Yeah, Mina, I'm Raymond Sheriff Kamara. Mina set one of the CHOs. Now we start paramedical school. Let me stand for correct the person first. The paramedical school, not the Germans, them come with them. Now the British come with them. The training advisor by then, now Dr. Rosemary McMahon. I listened briefly to what the minister been the talk, then I don't listen to all the other workers there. So we get a pool of community health officers there. We be this BMBM term, Nine can put chief community health officer. We problems. It don't start long years ago. From the first time when they begin train we, would Dr. McMahon bring that, make the, at first they say medical assistance. That creates serious problem to the extent that he able convince them, then change the name to community health officer. Just like how the previous callers, the previous people that would talk, wouldn't talk exactly and so the thing happened. Like me, so personally, what I did in a Freetown, we don't go several times now the previous government, the health minister office for make we go advocate for rich who side and not rich now. No way, no, they're not able to give we anyway,
Sheriff, take we back. What really happened? We make then they frown at making the CSO, the CHO's license. What in they just want them for practice without license, or what in not the bone of contention between the CHO's and make them receive that license?
In the first instance, what in they actually make will. They raise up their eyebrows. Now the curriculum, first what they mean see. So by then, they not been the know about community health in that way. always in the nobles, doctor, nurses, that not that hospital-based healthcare. Now they be noble no more. So what is mommy come now first upon first before then they even open that school day. When they open that school day, when they see the curriculum, some doctors them. I remember in those days, 1984. Some doctors them, Sierra Leone doctors them. They say you're waiting at the difference now between CHOs and doctors. The money get for convince them back because community health abroad. So therefore, the mommy tailor we cause for get a little bit of curative, promotive, preventive, rehabilitative medicine, small. Then it train we to the extent that if you recognized anything with a person to them, now for that then tell we say as you recognize something, so this is like the next level way for care and go. But oh, that's been done turn problem. For make the way they were able to accept we. From that time, the 30 days they were able to accept we. Me myself, then at that place there, I work in the Ministry of Health till to the time when they come America. So they're not able. Myself personally, we go to the previous government, the Minister of Health, we sit down with them. The Chief Medical Officer right now, Chief Medical Officer, the CHO, the Chief CHO, we base na U building there. For make self then go give him an office inside you building a problem. So I don't know, but the best way we go able to get this thing, you get for lazy with him. His name Abu Conte. You get for lazy with him, make you know the history of this there. So we don't fetch stay, we don't make tail, no headway will not they see. Up to this time. In fact, we get Boku Sages they would in America right now, like as I talk so. Now for that, today I listen. Well, then they talk now. I say, make a try. Sometime I will be fortunate for join this day or so. But don't you just imagine from 1984, the first batch come out 86, 87. We don't need struggle 30 days. Me like we saw now. I don't do some na situation like outbreaks they did all that they train with. Then I be reading the minister you talk say how some of the deal we know they're not train we in management business. No, then train we in everything. Management, health center management, pharmacy management, because them base that curriculum they because of the shortage of medical staff. So therefore then train we in bits. They're not training into details, so, but then train we in bits that you're able to do a lot of things. Then anything we recognize, say, this day above me, you refer them to the next level. But me brother, if I begin to tell you waiting on pass during the time, but we didn't at the field safe, you're not going to believe. Until we actually fear and truthful to we safe, I'm afraid. Most of us, you don't know more. They can't talk saying like this and this. We don't come out a long way. And the person will go able to give you the breakdown. Now, like the chief CHO, who based now you build it. He did it. His name Abu Conte.
Well, we'll go try for a reach out to Abu Conte. And maybe we'll go able to get him for bringing him on board. Make he can tell we small thing about how far, because you listen to it in Boka, he say yeah, even listen, this present he minister, he promised last year, even right now, this is October, he still promised the same thing. So then people in the talk center from the 80s, these promises. So when are we going to see this change? When are we going to see the CHOs being licensed?
My brother, that day we don't depend on if you draw Abu Conte go break them vividly to you, because he did it now you build it. He did it for make them get office safe. Now this behind the enter, now they can get office. But this now long business, long, and it just start like the health business. We they try for, in fact, any aspect of Sierra Leone right now, even to the remotest areas there, CHO, DD, We don't try. We don't know actually which we do them. Then we don't use all sorts of tactics until when CHO members then go into politics, then they inside parliament before ever we begin see something better they come out. But really not a problem. And we get for be sincere, we face them. Because if they say health, now we all get them. Now for the country, now for we own people then. But they get boku strategies. We then they try for lockdown on people then no more. Then we then come, then very flamboyant, they talk whatever thing this, that. But just like you suggest, call Abu Konte, we get a lot of CHOs then Denayaso. Will it be something we all go, we'll get for contribute so that we're going to know the core cause, but you don't see.
All right. Thank you very much, Sheriff. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Definitely, we will try to get hold of Abu Konte, we Naina the head for CHO, the chairperson. As we talk now, somebody don't already text me Abu Konte in your number. So definitely tomorrow we'll go reach out to him. Let we see if one day next week we can bring him come. Let we learn really waiting make the no one lies in them. And we try to forget from the other side. Well, we are waiting the minister don't say. But definitely we go try make we bring some exposure, you know, make we bring some exposure to this issue. Mary B, he said, Triple A, he say, we dey first. He say, everything. Now when? Say come on, it say even inside 2019 the population they grow. How we go able for develop and stabilize the infrastructure before things get even worse. Now make we say we hold on to waiting the Planning and Economic Development Minister, Dr. Francis Kankai tell me. He said, me could ask developmental questions. So if we really want this particular aspect, the health sector for grow, and when you check the work of the CHOs them, Usai doctors they know they had to reach areas they, na then didi. And if then they call, say, they for recognize them, they need for licensing them, I think it's a fair share. How we go get a better health, affordable? Remember, few months ago, they talk about the launching of that particular one day. Where the people them way for make, then they reach fine, now they hard to reach areas them. Because they talk them over and over, Freetown is not Sierra Leone. So we not for abandon the people them now the provinces. Who say now bike no more they go the motor cannot be able to reach the. Even some side you get for left the bike and continue on foot. And those are the people that we the goody. I know how we start the program and how we end them. It's like it's like a different route, but that's how we do. You know, we will lock. Today on program we go lock them because we're not go able for deal with everything in one day, but I believe say we will try forget somebody we will can explain give you what to make that family life education they don't pull them come on at this school curriculum. And if we talk about teenage pregnancy, if we talk about hands of our girls, if we talk about all entire not to inside big field number for good one. No, if suppose for it's a conversation where for they get in a school with the picking them, even the parents themselves get for the learn how for get them conversation then they. That's in the we go able to save Pekin from born in Pekin. And I see somebody they comment say, oh, now because of waiting the Pekin and they were, you don't say Pekin. You don't say Pekin. And I don't care waiting somebody where or waiting nowhere. Even if he get the rights, he use that right, they say it's my right for work a half naked. Then they know warrant you for good put on para for good torture. So it's sickening for see where man then they try for defend such. Because even the other time, 2 weeks ago, AYV on Sunday, then they do that sex for great. You see somebody team up say, now waiting the picking and the way go. Go na school. Now in the cause all, na college. Now in the cause all landy. Again, we blame the laws of the land. Because in the West, now the law, now in the make you, if Pekin can't talk to yourself, small, we know say this na Pekin. I like you one flirt with you, you the freed. Because when they come, not to the Pekin and they ask. Now you the grown up, now you na the problem. So, I know when it comes to this topic, people can always get their own ideology. But it is what it is. And I think, say, we will begin to get just a car from Miss Bokari. We go to count once a month. Because in the na the field, they make could they can't talk and make could they get in conversation, yeah. Make could they get in conversation, yeah, eh? Judge Kamaya says, say, for the get more midwife for reduce the rate of infant mortality. And again, then we don't promise, we say, then go train. Then midwives, then them are midway, they put to bed, then, you know, then, now then community and all them things, and they say, and we don't say them go, they train them and make them salon. May God help us. May God help salon, yeah? Again, with a lock to their own program now, we'll go there back tomorrow. And make we see waiting tomorrow, go can lay na table. Till we meet again tomorrow, Triple S, Tata.